Hello everyone, so far we are done with the admin panel and now we will be doing the student login. There are student login is a small it's a small entity. All you have to understand the concept of it, and then you have to study how a student form is generated, sorry, teacher form is generated and how a student fill that. So let's get started with the student login, sorry, student panel. So here's the student panel. Let me give a password. BCS1. Hey, is it not working again? Seek the password. I forgot that. Even let's change a password. Password, username and password. Okay, his roll number is the username and password is his password. Okay, so there the basic concept over here is give the student authentication form, or you want, if you want to do it on a username, you can make a new user field over here and make it the username, or you can just use the same. Teacher assessment, which subject he want to assessment, and his password. If he want to change the password, let's suppose he is making an A. Let's check it out. His password change and he's been logged out. So if I give this and give a password A, so he will be logged in. Okay, so I think the manage password will be easy, nothing to do with that. Here's the profile of the student. All you have to do is just the fetch the data from the database and show it over here of the student. But you have to do what? At the login time, you have to put the user ID into the session, and with that session, you can get the data of the student which is logged in. So if you go over here, let me show you student login, and here's the profile. Studentinfo.php. So if you can say that he's getting the user ID from the session, as I told you, and getting the user ID, and here what he is doing is that selecting the student from the database, sorry, here selecting the student from the database where the student user ID is equal to student ID over here. So basically the concept is whenever you are making a login, make that login ID the login user ID into a session, and whenever you want to deal with that person, that user, you can just grab the ID from the session and put it in the query. So it's the form, and the other is teacher assessment. So first of all, we need to assign a assessment form to this student. His name is let me give it. Let's make it a AA edit. You can also do like this, double click and make it a A. So it will be updated. So log out back, go to the admin. Assessment department, which department he is student is, he's in department 1, I think, which department, let's see, go to department ID. Yes, he's in computer science department, and he is in his program 3. Okay, and he's in semester 3. Okay, he's in program which is the program ID, sorry, let me check it out. Program ID is the his program ID is 3 3 3. Let's make it 2, just to get the our need program ID. Oh, it's 1 department, sorry, program ID is 3. Yeah, basically it is 3. change it again. Make it 3. Okay. So here's the program 3. Select the subject C++ and submit. So if we go back, let's localhost maybe student make it a and sorry, well, it's not coming. Here's the student assessment form. Click on here and it's new. So fill it up. You have to fill it. Sorry, teacher are always good. No, I'm noting none. What am I doing? Make it. I need to make this buttons. Please you comment. Be careful. I read and submit. Whenever you submit, this check sign was over that you have submitted the this teacher and everything you have done it. Okay, so here's the assessment form. This was the logic. See you in the next video, and I will be explaining all this logic of with the coding. Thank you. Don't forget to like and share. And if you like our video, if you like this project, if this project really helped you in your work, please try to subscribe.